Good afternoon, friends. I, Professor Pramod Magade, teaching you the DME2, Design of Machinery Element 2, for the division C and D. So, other students also, A and B division, can refer this video for fourth unit, worm gear design. Now, we have seen in previous units, before INSEM, spur gear and helical gear, in which we have seen the design procedure. So, how the design of the gears are performed. So, accordingly, we will perform the design of worm gear also. Now, here what happened, you can see under the classification, we have seen in classification, there are the four type of classification. First is when shaft axis is parallel, in that case, spur, helical, double helical, that is herringbone bone gear, rack and pinion, and internal gears can be used for parallel shaft arrangement, that we have seen. Then for perpendicular shaft axis or intersecting shaft axis, we have seen the bevel gear design. Now this will be the third type, that is non-intersecting perpendicular shaft axis. You can see the axis of the worm as well as a, this is worm and this is gear. So it is non-intersecting but perpendicular to the each other. So likewise, we are going to design under this criteria. So first of all, I'll tell you the structure of the worm. As like a previous gears, like spur, helical, both pinion and gear are circular. Now right now, these are not circular. You can see this will be the gear portion and this will be the worm portion. In case of the worm, it is circular and worm is like a screw. So it will maintain the shape of the screw. So here, for that meshing purpose, we are not going to use the ratio factor here, Q, that was the value which we had derived. Now this will be the structure. You just first understand the structure. So this is worm, screw like structure, and this is gear, circular structure. Now I hope you'll get the idea what is the worm gear. Now I'll show you the animated video of the worm gear. You can see the blue one is gear and black one is a worm. Generally, it can be used for the high gear ratio. Why this so? Because generally worm gear spares are used in heavy load application such as lift cranes, in case of elevators for opening and closing of the dam gate. So in that case we are using. So this will be the arrangement. Now next point is introduction. I'll tell you, basically I told you the shaft axis, non-intersecting perpendicular shaft axis, the worm is a driver always, and worm wheel is a driven member, that is circular portion. It is having multiple start. Why? Because you can see the worm is working, this black portion, worm is working according to number of start. It's same as that of a power screw which we had seen in previous semester. In that power screw we had seen the lifting and lowering torque. For that purpose we are using number of start. So number of start generally we can calculate according to lead, L is equal to P, that is single started screw. It means one rotation of the gear, one thread will move forward, that is single started. If double started, L is equal to twice of P, which we have seen. If triple started, L is equal to thrice of P, and so on. So such kind of the multi-start threads are there in case of the worm gear. So that was our third point. Now next point is, it has having same end of helix at the time of the rotation. If worm gear is having right hand, so definitely worm like screw structure is also having right hand. It has having self-locking property. So I told you what is self-locking property, in which friction angle is more than helix angle, that is friction self-locking. We had taken the example of the power screw in previous semester, that if the power screw I am using for four-wheeler Maruti 800, so I will have to maintain the height I can hold at that time. So that we can say that self-locking, as per my requirement I can adjust the screw. So that is self-locking. Here also same, it is always a self-locking type of the screw in case of the worm. Now advantage, basic advantage of the worm gear, it has high reduction ratio, and generally that reduction is 60:1. So it can be used in various sizes as per the application of the load condition. Now, self-locking maintains self-locking and non-reversible process. It will work smoothly and silent operation. So these are the basic advantage of the worm gear pair. Now you can see the limitations. Basically, it is difficult to manufacture. Why? Because lot many time what happened, as per the structure of the worm, power screw like structure worm, I will have to design on the basis of the thread type, and that thread type I will have to continue for the worm gear wheel. So for that case, it will be difficult to the manufacturer, because both are manufactured separately. Worm gear is generally used by the casting process or phosphor bronze material, which is circular, which can be cast, and complicated shape can be easily manufactured. But in case of the thread, that is worm, we need to use a specialized tool. So the cost is more, that's why it is difficult to, cost is more and also design is complicated, so difficult to manufacture, it is more expensive and less efficiency. I'll tell you why less. Less means what? Generally what happened, the gears having gear ratio is more, then its efficiency always less. How? Now see, I told you the gear ratio is 60:1. We know the gear ratio equation, it is equal to in terms of Zg by Zp. So here Zp is not there. In case of pinion, I'll use Zw, that is worm. And the value of Zg is more. It means that the size is more. And definitely, if size is more, the RPM are less of the worm and pinion is more. So in that case, what happened? The efficiency due to its more gear ratio is always reduced, or that gear is not will give the efficiency, and that efficiency range is around 50% to 80% max. The more heat will be generated, because heavy load conditions can be carried by the worm gear pair. So more heat will be generated and it required the proper cooling. Correct. So these are the somewhat limitations. Now we'll move toward the applications. As I told you, it can be used for heavy load conditions such as the hoisting devices, cranes, lift, dam gates for opening and closing as per the requirement, steering mechanism. So in that case, worm gear pair is used.